was the Seahorses' biggest hit and the only song to gain popularity outside the United Kingdom. Yeah, it did well.
That's not bad for considering it's their only album, right?
Their only album. Yeah, yeah. It reached number 11 in Ireland. It did well in Sweden. Yeah, I think even in Canada, it even did well. I don't think it did much here in the United States. But, you know, so much for the record companies in the United States. You know, they just, yeah, they don't know good music if it bites them on the ass sometimes. But, you know.
Hey, welcome back to Into the Music. I'm here with Greg. My name is Chris. And Greg, you got something for me to react to? I'm really hoping it's good.
Yes. Now the pressure's on me. Okay. I'm nervous as hell. So I got the band called Seahorses. And the song is Love is the Law. Love is
the law.
The law. Yeah. So I guess the love, right? I mean, if you're in love, love should be your guiding sort of principle, right? As to how you live your life, right? And treat your partner.
I was thinking more like if you got pulled over by a cop and you're like, hey, officer, love is the law, man.
Yeah, and then he probably gives you a bigger ticket.
Strap.
Hey, I see you back from playing around with the seahorses.
I'm swinging in my chair, so you know what that means.
No, we actually didn't really conclude, right? Like, what does that mean? It could mean...
Yeah, we did.
It means a good thing?
Like, if I had a tail, it'd be wagging.
All right, so tell me about it. Cool.
Okay, well, this song, okay.
I was nervous about this song a lot. I kept taking this off my list. I know I cut you off.
You didn't think I'd like it.
Yeah. I didn't because it's very Oasis kind of sounding.
It is?
And in the very beginning, you can possibly mistake the guy's voice in the very beginning, like the first maybe three or four words. Maybe, is this Liam? You know, I thought maybe you were like, what? You know?
Did you slip him in somehow?
But, you know, and it does have that, you know, and I'll tell you, but there's that sort of, you know, feel that sort of, yeah. I just, for some reason, I didn't know. I thought once you got through the actual song, like, you know, the singing part, and you got to the instrumentation, then I'll shut up. You know, then I thought I had a chance. And so anyway, so go ahead. Sorry. I'm excited though. I'm really excited that you like it. Go ahead.
You are correct.
Wow.
Yeah, the first couple of minutes, they're okay.
Yeah.
And I thought, okay, so this is like over 7 minutes, right? This
song? Yeah. So you looked at the time and you went, that Greg.
Yes, I checked the time.
It was one of those, and Greg.
I like this better change. Yeah, that's really like but then it did.
Yeah.
It changed. It went into that part where it wasn't just the bass and vocals, but that was the main thing that was going on when all the other instrumentations stopped.
Yeah.
There was some other stuff going on in the background. But when that started, I thought, okay, all right, now it's starting to get interesting. And then later on, it had this really, really groovy kind of bass line going on.
Yeah.
The bass was kicking it. And then the guitar came in.
Yeah.
Kicked in. And then I was like, okay, all right, we're good now, you know.
Right.
But those first couple of minutes, I was thinking, yeah, I'm not. It was good the first couple of minutes.
Right.
Nothing wrong with it, but it didn't grab me.
But yeah,
then
no.
When the other stuff after that couple of minutes went by, I was totally cool with it. And the singing's fine too. The singing's good. So,
and you know, you and I always shooting for not just, oh, it was okay. You know, we're trying to get the, yeah, that was really good. That's playlist. You know, that's kind of like the ultimate goal, right, with these. So I didn't think that you were going to hate the actual, you know, typical song structure part, you know, with the singing and like that and the melody. No, I didn't think you were going to hate it, but I thought it might have been like, okay, all right, you know, that's nice. You know, that's nice. Pat it on the head. Nice. And then you kind of like, you know, go off, little boy. You know, okay, you
know. I kind of was like that in the beginning, yeah.
Yeah. And then it was like,
but it definitely, if it had been going in that vein for the through the whole thing,
right,
and had like a
right
more typical kind of lead break and so on, it wouldn't have done anything for me.
So let me tell you a little bit about the song.
Tell me about it.
Love is the Lore is the debut single of Britpop, and I'm looking at Wiki.
Really?
Of Brit. Surprise. A Britpop band, The Seahorses, released as their first single from their only studio album, Do It Yourself, 1997. It was written by ex-Stone Roses guitarist John Squire. That's the guy that you heard going crazy at the end.
On the guitar.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. I don't know if when you were listening to that, if it sounded reminiscent of, like, you know, I've heard, you know, this sounds a little bit like something, or guitar sound.
I wasn't thinking in that direction. I was just kind of listening to the song. I wasn't really thinking of what. Nothing struck me as like it sounds like this or that.
Okay. This was the Seahorses' biggest hit and the only song to gain popularity outside the United Kingdom. It did well.
It's not bad for considering it's their only album, right?
Their only album, yeah. Yeah, it reached number 11 in Ireland. It did well in Sweden. I think even in Canada, it even did well. I don't think it did much here in the United States. But, you know, so much for the record companies in the United States. You know, they just, yeah, they they don't know good music if it bites them on the ass sometimes. But I loved it. This go ahead.
When did this come out?
1997.
97, okay.
So the Seahorses, you know, as we were dropping some Stone Roses songs, a while back, every once in a while in the comments section, John Squires does, Squires done a lot more stuff, the Seahorses. So I'm like, so I finally thought, okay, let me look into the Seahorses. And I mean, they only had the one album, and John Squire, he kind of has a negative view about that time. He looks back on it. Some of the quotes that I saw from him that, it was probably something that he shouldn't have gotten into,
What, doing this project with this band?
But he's been very self-reflective, even about his time with the Stone Roses and stuff. There's like almost like a negative tone to a lot of stuff, and when you look at what he's produced, he's created with the Stone Roses and his solo projects and everything else. And with this band, it's just amazing stuff. He's also an artist, he did the Stone Roses, couple of albums, he also did the artwork for this one. And he's a painter. I was actually watching a video about him and he's just, he's like really, really, really good. So this has been kind of requested, this band, and this song was dropped a couple times too in the comments section. I love that guitar part at the end. It's fantastic. It's just holy crap. And you know me in guitar, and I know you in guitar, and I thought, it would be a crime if I didn't have Chris listen to this.
Crime.
So there you go. So I'll let you have the final word on this. Take it out.
This is good stuff. It may go on a playlist. I'm not sure. I got to listen to it again. Okay. Maybe I'll edit the first 2 minutes out.
Actually, it's going to grow on you. I think it's going to grow on you because I think there's really good harmonizing with that part too. I think the vocalist is really strong. Yeah. You're good. Yeah. If I had to put my money down, I think you'd put the whole song on your playlist really soon. But anyway, so go take us out, sir.
Okay. So thanks for watching. Subscribe if you haven't yet and hit that like button if you like this. And Greg and I will catch you next time on Into the Music.
See ya.